There are a whopping 43 different landmarks to build in Age of Empires 4, and it's time to get a closer look to each one of them, both graphically and gameplay-wise. Welcome to Age of Noob, everyone, and let's talk about that. Alright, let's begin with the English. To advance to the Feudal Age, the English can either construct the military landmark of Council Hall, which can produce longbows at twice the speed and upgrade them, or the religious landmark of Abbey of Kings, which heals all nearby friendly units that are out of combat by 4 every 1.5 seconds. To advance to the Castle Age, the English can construct the economic landmark of King's Palace, which pretty much acts exactly as a town center, or the defensive landmark of the White Tower, which pretty much acts as a keep. Nothing fancy in either landmarks here. To advance to the Imperial Age, the English can construct the defensive landmark of Berkshire Palace, which also acts as a keep but has a 50% greater weapon range and double the number of arrow slits, or the military landmark of Wingard Palace, which can produce the Wingard Army as seen on screen. Moving on to the Chinese, they can either construct the economic landmark of Imperial Academy, which doubles the tax gold for nearby buildings, or the defensive landmark of Barbican of the Sun, which fires a long-range hand cannon and adds arrow slits when garrisoned. It also provides vision into stealth forests. To advance to the Castle Age, they can either build the military landmark of Astronomical Clock Tower, which acts as a siege workshop and produces siege engines with 50% more health, or the economic landmark of Imperial Palace, which not only has a large sight radius, but can see enemy villagers for 10 seconds when activated. To advance to the Imperial Age, the Chinese can choose from the defensive landmark of the Great Wall Gatehouse, which can only be built over stone walls, doubles the health of the stone walls and gates, and buffs the damage of nearby military units by 50%, or the military landmark of Spearway, which also allows the creation of unlocked dynasty units on all buildings, and nearby buildings get a 30% cost reduction on said units. Moving back to Europe, the French can choose between the economic landmark of the Chamber of Commerce, which acts as a market and increases returns by 30%, or the military landmark of the School of Cavalry, which acts as a stable and buffs all stable production by 20% to advance to the Feudal Age. To advance to the Castle Age, the French can choose from the military landmark of the Royal Institute, which houses all French technologies, is 20% cheaper, and ignores any age requirements, or the economic landmark of Guildhall, which generates and stores resources over time. Keep an eye out on this, as this landmark might get nerfed soon. Finally, the French can choose from the defensive landmark of Red Palace, which acts as a keep and features high damage arbalest emplacements, or the military landmark of College of Artillery, which provides immediate access to produce Royal Artillery, which does 20% more damage to advance to the Imperial Age. If we head to the steppes next, the Mongols can choose between the military landmark of Deerstones, which provides the Yam Speed Aura and instantly grants the Yam Network technology, or the economic landmark of the Silver Tree, which acts as a market and can build traders 50% faster and 50% less gold to advance to the Feudal Age. To advance to the Castle Age, the Mongols can either construct the military landmark of Kurultai, which, when the Khan is nearby, has healing and bonus damage effects, or the economic landmark of Step Redoubt, which acts as a gur that increases the gold dropped off at it by 50%. For the Imperial Age, the Mongols can choose from the economic landmark of the White Stope, which acts as an ovu that doesn't need a stone outcropping to function, or the military landmark of the Kagan Palace, which spawns a cav army of horsemen, mangadai, or lancers every 90 seconds. Heading north, the Rus advance to the Feudal Age by constructing either the defensive landmark of Kremlin, which acts as a wooden fortress that comes with arrow slits, castle turret, and castle watch technologies, or the economic landmark of the Golden Gate, which allows the exchange of resources at a favorable rate, kind of like the Saracen market from Age of Empires 2. To advance to the Castle Age, the Rus can pick from the economic landmark of High Trade House, which generates gold like a hunting cabin but by more than 200% and spawns deer every 60 seconds, or the religious landmark of Abbey of the Trinity, which acts as a monastery and produces warrior monks at half the cost, alongside unique religious technologies. Finally, the Rus can construct either the defensive landmark of Spaskaya Tower, which acts as a keep with all weapon emplacements already in place and with increased health, or the military landmark of High Armory, which decreases the cost of siege engines for nearby workshops by 20% and contains unique siege technologies to advance to the Imperial Age. Moving on, the Delhi Sultanate advances to the Feudal Age by constructing either the military landmark of Tower of Victory, which buffs nearby melee and rage infantry permanently with 15% attack speed, or the religious landmark of Dome of the Faith, which produces scholars for half the cost. To advance to the castle age, they can pick from either the defensive landmark of Compound of the Defender, which provides the ability to build stone walls, gates, and towers to infantry while reducing their cost by 25%, or the technology landmark of House of Learning, which pretty much does nothing but provide unique technologies to research. Finally, the Delhi Sultanate can advance to the Imperial Age by constructing either the technology landmark of Hisar Academy, which constantly generates food based on the number of technology already researched, or the Palace of the Sultan, which automatically produces tower war elephants and can also garrison 4 scholars to increase its production speed. The civilization that is neither holy, nor Roman, nor an empire, the Holy Roman Empire, can advance to the Feudal Age by constructing the military landmark of Minework Palace, which acts like a blacksmith and provides a discount of 25%, or the religious landmark of the Ashen Chapel, which inspires units in a large radius as long as a prelate is garrisoned. To advance to the Castle Age, the Holy Roman Empire can pick from the religious landmark of Reknitz Cathedral, which generates 3 times the gold when a relic is garrisoned, or the military landmark of Burgrave Palace, which acts as a barracks that can produce infantry 5 at a time. Finally, they can advance to the Imperial Age by constructing either the economic landmark of Palace of Swabia, which acts as a town center but produces them 75% faster and 75% cheaper, or the defensive landmark of Elsbach Palace, which acts as a keep with 50% more health and reduces damage to nearby buildings by a third. The final civilization, the Abbasid dynasty, does not construct landmarks to age up. Instead, they construct the House of Wisdom from Baghdad, and researching technologies constructs one of the 4 wings: military, economy, culture, and trade. Each time you research a new wing, you will see a new wing constructed and added to the main House of Wisdom structure. Well, that's pretty much it, folks. I know this is a ton of new information that you need to memorize, but that's okay, as we'll break the game down bit by bit until we internalize the game's civilizations and mechanics. Age of Noob will have you covered with more informational videos in the upcoming days. There are a ton of new videos still on the pipeline, as I'm trying my best to give you folks the quality videos that you have been waiting for Age of Empires 4. If you'd like to stay up to speed, please consider subscribing to not miss out on any AoE content. As always, thanks so much for watching, and see you all in the next one.